open pattern set 2 and we'll double click inside the pattern in the center to open it in the editor. We're going to create a pattern for a magnetic picture frame and we'll get to use most of the creation tools in the process. First, I'll draw a heart in the center. To make sure it gets centered, I'll snap a line from the center top to the center bottom. I want the heart to occupy about half the height of the frame, so I'll create points on the center line, 30% from the top and bottom. Using the point at a distance tool, I'll set the percentage to 30, set the ratioed button to both ends, and click Add Points. I'll draw one half of the heart, then mirror it about the center line. I can use either the spline or the Bezier tool to draw the curve for the heart. I'll do one each way and then use my favorite. Starting with the Bezier curve tool, I'll snap the first point to the top point on the center line, then click to create the next few points. The tool can make a curve after I've created the fourth point. It will look like a polyline until then. I'll press the snap key to see the bottom center line point, then click there. To end the Bezier, right click. I can switch to the selector and move points and handles until I'm satisfied with the shape. I'll draw the other side using the spline tool. I snap to the top point, click to add interior points, and snap to the bottom point. I'll change to the selector tool and move a few points until I like the shape. Now I'll pick my favorite half, delete the other, and mirror about the center line. We want a circle in the top left quadrant, so I'll select the circle tool from the conics dropdown. I pick a center point by eye and click to start there, then move the mouse out until I like the size. Now change to the selector and move the circle until it's positioned about equally from the top and left edges and the edge of the heart. Now I'll delete the number 2 in the corner. Next, we'll create an ellipse in the lower right quadrant. Select the Ellipse tool from the conics dropdown. I'll click to position the center of the ellipse, then move the mouse up and to the right to create the ellipse. The A and B measures will show in the content panel. I'll click again when I like the size and proportions of the ellipse. I'm going to change to the selector so I can adjust the shape using the handles and then move the ellipse into position, approximately equidistant from both edges and the heart. We'll add a rectangle opening in the lower left quadrant. I'll select the rectangle tool from the polygons dropdown. I click to start the rectangle close to the lower left corner, then move the mouse and click to finish the rectangle. I'll change to the selector and move the rectangle into approximate position. Typing Ctrl B will break it into four lines. We want fillets in all the corners. I'll select the Arc Fillet tool from the Fillet dropdown and set the radius to 1/2 inch. Now I'll right-click to deselect, then select one edge and mouse over its neighbor. When I see the fillet, I'll click to accept. We'll do the same thing for the other three corners. We want to group these elements together to make it easier to select the cutout, so I'll change back to the selector, drag a marquee around them all, and click the group icon. Now I can move this cutout into final position. The last cutout will be an octagon in the top right quadrant. I'll select the polygon tool from the polygons dropdown, set the number of sides to 8, and click on center to side for the length measurement. I'll click where I want the center, then move the mouse and the polygon will form. When I have a good size, I'll click to accept. We can change to the selector now and move the octagon into a final position equidistant from both edges and the heart. We no longer need our center line, so I'll select it and delete it. We want to cut with a 40-degree knife blade, so I'll select everything by typing Ctrl A, then set them all to the Knife 40 tool. We want to add 1-inch fillets at the outside corners, so I'll select the Arc Fillet tool from the Fillet dropdown and set the radius to 1-inch. I'll select the top line, then mouse over the left side line. When the fillet appears, just click to accept. We'll do the same thing for each corner. Before I save the frame pattern, I want to set its elements as the nesting perimeter. I'll go to the Perimeter tab and click on Elements. If any corners have a gap, we'll see a red stop sign there. Our pattern looks good, so I'll click Done and save the work.